In our previous videos, we discussed how to determine when email is the right tool and the mechanics of an email. In this segment, we will cover the do's and don'ts of email etiquette. When sending an email, using the proper greeting to address your recipient is important. If an email is formal or you are communicating with someone you don't know for the first time, use dear and Mr., Ms., or Mrs. along with their last name. Formal emails, like formal letters, start with the recipient's name followed by a colon, not a comma. Commas, as in dear Mr. Wiley, indicate an informal relationship typical of a friendly letter. You can be less formal after you have received a response from the person and made one or more email exchanges. How the person signs his email will give you an indication of whether you should keep it formal or can take it to a more casual tone. Using hello is professional and friendly, and is considered appropriate when you are addressing someone you know or have been associated with for a while. Hi is casual and conversational and more appropriate for people you have regular email communications with. Avoid using hey. It is slang and should not be used in a professional setting under any circumstances. Keeping the content of your email accurate and concise is important in getting your message read and understood. A few key tips include: keep your formatting simple. Always come across friendly, respectful, and approachable. Be sure your message is not offensive. Do not be curt or demanding. Remember, the tone of your email should always be positive, as mentioned in our first video. Always put your important information at the top. Keep your message brief and to the point, focusing on one topic. If you have several items to discuss, use bullets or consider sending multiple emails with an appropriate subject line. This will make it easier to find emails later if there is a need to refer back to information you are sending. Remind people who you are if you only met briefly or if it has been a while. On the flip side, if you met with someone as recently as an hour ago, it is important to remind them in the email why you are writing. In this multitasking world of ours, it is easy for even the sharpest minds to forget what's going on. Be sure your email focuses on business. Emails should not be used for gossip, and do not use your personal email account for business messages. Don't underline words or information, as it can be mistaken for a hyperlink. If you receive a message you think is a hoax, use Snopes.com, an internet resource for misinformation, urban legends, or myths, before you forward the information. When sending an email that does not require a response, it is appropriate to include "no reply necessary" in the content of the email or the subject line. When replying to an email, set the appropriate tone. It is a good idea to thank the sender for their message. This shows a sense of courtesy and creates a positive beginning to your message, which is especially helpful if your response may be perceived negatively. When replying to an email, it is important to keep the original message. If the original email has a list of questions, it can be frustrating to receive multiple answers back without the original content appended. When you are responding to multiple questions, it is helpful to write your response under each question in a different color. This will make it easier for the recipient to read, and they will appreciate the effort you made. Occasionally, you might receive a dirty email. No, not that kind. We are talking about those funny little arrows called carrots. Be sure to remove all carrots when you are responding. Another thing that can dirty up multiple threads are the email addresses of numerous people when a message is sent to a group. Be sure to erase them so the content of each message is more prominent. One final thing to consider about content are inane responses. Have you ever put a lot of thought and effort into an email only to receive the response, "Okay," or "Sure"? Take the time to sufficiently acknowledge the sender's questions or issues. If you don't have time to provide a detailed response immediately, then an appropriate reply would be, "Thanks for the information. I'm swamped today. Let's get together and discuss in more detail tomorrow." When closing your email, end in a friendly, positive way using terms like best wishes, have a great day, or thanks. They are considered casual and more appropriate for the people you have regular contact with. If your message is more formal, use sincerely, kind or best regards, thank you, or many thanks, followed with your branded signature. Other areas of email etiquette to consider include the use of the confirmation or read receipt tool. This tool should only be used with important emails, not to everyone you send. If you will be out of the office for more than 24 hours and have limited or no access to email, consider using the out-of-office assistant found under the Tools tab of Outlook. Leave a phone number or name of a colleague the person can contact in case of an emergency. Do not use autoresponder to acknowledge receipt of an email, such as "thank you for your email" or "I will respond as soon as possible." This tool will further clutter the sender's inbox. If you are sending an email to announce a meeting and providing more information than you would include in a calendar invite, be sure to include all details such as date, time, and location. When canceling a meeting last minute, call instead of emailing, as the person may miss your notice. Sometimes we will use an old message to contact a specific group of people on a different topic. When doing so, be sure to erase the old message and create a new subject line before writing the new message and sending. Response time to email is critical, and failure to respond impacts everyone. In general, you should reply as quickly as possible and no longer than 24 to 48 hours after receiving the message. If you are unable to answer due to the need for information sourcing, acknowledge the email with a time frame to respond in. For example, "Thank you for your message. I am researching the information you requested and will send it to you no later than 5 p.m. tomorrow." If you need an immediate response to a question or request for information, consider calling the person. Do not call the recipient shortly after you send the email, as it can be annoying. If the email is urgent, mention it in the message. If you do not have a response after 24 to 48 hours and you are unsure if the email was received, it is then appropriate to call. Email, an important component of your daily communications, is a reflection of your professionalism and will leave a lasting impression. Follow these guidelines to build your message as you build lasting relationships.